Let's get our broom on.
Everybody grab a broom, and we shall get started. Mr. Clopton, your attention, please.
Sorry, Madam Kagawa.
Everyone, please welcome a new student to our flying class.
Welcome. Hello.
The goal of today is to remind all of you how to maneuver on a broomstick safely. As broom flight is, first and foremost, a means of transportation.
This, I fear, some of you have forgotten.
How can I forget?
Diving, rolling, and loop the loops will not be taught or in fact tolerated in this class. We'll leave that to professional Quidditch players, like the Toyohashi Tengu.
Boo.
Not a fan, I take it?
Now, let's see how well everyone kept up with their practice over the summer holidays. For those who need a refresher, step up to your broom. Say up firmly and clearly. Then kick your leg over and rest your weight on the seat.
And say up. With feeling.
Shut up, Harry.
Up!
Thank you.
Now, your turn.
Up!
Up!
Up, you stupid ratty school broom!
One leg over, so there's a leg on each side. None of that side saddle nonsense. A gust of wind will throw you right off. And if you hear my whistle while you're in flight, ground yourself at once. Good. Now, for your first lesson, fly through each ring in the courtyard. Do take care. The brooms are school property. I want them returned
this
in one piece.
I think I'm getting the hang of this.
Well done. Now that you're acclimatized to your broom, let's see how well you manage with a more advanced exercise, shall we? This next set of rings will take you around the grounds for more of a challenge.
What a view!
Hello! Nice day for a flight!
You're supposed to go through the rings, dumbass. Yep, you suck at this too.
The old boathouse. Wish you could have experienced the lake at first.
Oh my god, seriously, dude? Worst gamer ever. It ain't that hard, old man. Hallelujah.
Too bad.
Whoa, our aquatic resident likes to make an appearance once in a while.
Made it. Did anyone else see that? This is rather...
Oh, well done! Have a moment? I say, I watched you fly through those rings. You seem to handle yourself on that dusty school broom well enough. I'd imagine you're ready for something a bit more challenging. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We haven't properly met. I'm Everett Clopton. Am I right in suspecting that a Slytherin like you might be interested in making an escape from class?
Why are you continuously late for this class, Mr. Spicoli? Why do you shamelessly waste my time like this?
I don't know.
Can't say no to that. What did you have in mind?
A bit of a detour, so to speak. Follow me. The tour is about to begin. Follow closely now. Right now, we're flying over the Transfiguration Courtyard. Lovely as ever. Let's hope the headmaster isn't having tea by the window today. Ahead of the gardens, the Hufflepuff common room windows just peek out. Bit claustrophobic for my taste.
How is Everett flying so quickly?
Here's something handy to know. Lean forward for a burst of speed. Helpful if you need to escape a tricky situation.
Now that's more like it.
You sure you're not part hippogriff?
No, tiniest part stupid though.
There's the famous bridge. Think of all the magic holding it up. I mean, look at it. And the owlery. That's a bit of solid architecture, isn't it?
Plenty of and a jaunt around Hogwarts. This is quite the tour, Everett.
That's Kagawa's whistle. This concludes our tour. Let's hurry back. She's already dismissed class. Better hurry and hand in our brooms. Dismount here.
And where have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions. Mr. Clopton, I am disappointed in you. You're in this class because you're still not showing yourself, or frankly, your broom, the proper respect.
But, Professor...
Enough. Class is finished for the day. As for you... You do well to use better judgment in the future. Chin up. That was some rather good fly.
Were you watching someone else?
Sorry about that business with Kagawa, but you have to admit, those views were worth it.
It was worth losing a few house points for that detour.
You seem at home on a broom.
Bet if you had a fancy model, you could fly laps around Imelda. She's Kagawa's favorite. I could show her a thing or two if I had my own broom. Hate having to return the school broom after class.
Perhaps I'll have to purchase a broom then.
If you can, you should. Wish I could. I recommend visiting Albie Weeks at Spintwitch's in Hogsmeade. He's always looking to test new models. I'll keep an eye out for you in the sky.
The Quiditch Pitch Broom Trial.
The nerve. Why is he roping you into his broom testing silliness? You've barely started flying from what I know. Caught wind of you showing off in flying class with Clopton.
Seen someone's jealous of my skills on a broom.
Me, Slytherin Quidditch captain, jealous of you. Everyone knows that class is only for beginners, troublemakers, and bumbling baboons. But for some reason, now people think you're competition. I can't be having that.
Perhaps I am competition.
You can't be what passes for Slytherin these days. Ragged old hat's dropping its standards. Enough of this. Only one way to find out who's the better flyer. I hold one of the fastest times on this course. Let's see if you can beat it. Slytherin versus Slytherin.
Actually, why not? I can beat your record.
I'm so looking forward to seeing you lose.
Snob.
Made it! Excellent.
Here we go again.
You won. Don't think this is over. You can't determine skill from one single trial.
Surely my win means something.
You're not terrible, but you're still going to have to prove yourself if you want to earn my respect.
Respect is earned here, not granted.
I don't want respect from the likes of you. All you do is insult people.
You and everyone else need to get a thicker skin.
Okay, Karen.
Anyway, I'm moving on to the next course. It's near Irondale and offers a much tougher challenge. You can try to prepare by racing this course again. Just check in at the podium, where the leaderboard is. You can check your time and start the race. We'll see next time if your win here was more than just a fluke, whilst on an errand for Albie Weeks.
I suspect Mr. Weeks will be glad to hear how I fared.
Thank you. you're back. With something to report, I hope.
Mr. Weeks, I was able to set a record on my broom.
Incredible! Miss Reyes must have been shocked. Tell me, how was the broom?
A little turbulent and is wanting for a bit of speed, but it fared well enough. I will say that it tended to drift a bit to the left on certain turns. Heard a slight swoosh when I dipped.
Oh, thank you. That's precisely what I needed to know. Drifted, eh? I shall get to work immediately. Even the naysayers will be forced to admit that my work's had potential all along.
I'm excited to hear more.
I have a very good feeling about this upgrade. I guarantee you'll be pleased. Expect to hear from me soon.
Hogwarts South Broom Trial.
I must tell you, half of Hogsmeade's been by the shop asking about rumours of a broom upgrade. Without the information you provided, my work would have taken twice as long. Thank you again. It may sound ambitious, but I've already begun work on another upgrade, more difficult to perfect than the last. I wondered, would you be interested in joining forces again? There's another course near Irondale that Miss Reyes has mastered. If you were to test this first upgrade there, it may help me as I develop the next. Oh, you'll consider it, won't you?
What more can you tell me about the next course?
It's just a jaunt from here. South of Hogsmeade, beautiful mountain views. The course was designed to test flyer stamina. Some of your classmates mentioned they were headed there, eager to see what Imelda has in store. A bit surprising, considering many of them expressed reticence at the idea of racing against her at all. I hope that won't deter you, and you'll give the course a go. At least think on it.
Sounds as if you're really outdoing yourself. If I'm able to help, I will.
Thank you. I know this recent success was only the beginning of what I can do for broom flight.
Here we are. Mr. Weeks wasn't wrong about the mountain views.
If it isn't the second best Slytherin.
If it isn't Snooty McSnobberton.
Hello, Imelda. So, another trial?
Of course it's another trial. And you'd better be taking part.
So what? You finally scared everyone else away?
Oh, I have plenty of challengers. They're just not very good. No one sets records by wishing for them. And I need strong competition to stay on top of my game. Are you going to try to beat my flying record or not?
I'm ready to fly.
Finally, a decent challenge.
Get together, Tubby.
I'd say that was acceptable. wasn't planned. Made it! Now that's more like it!
Do it again, fat man.
Hello again, Imelda. Is your challenge still on the table?
That all depends. Are you ready this time?
I'm ready to fly.
Finally, a decent challenge.
Close, but not close enough. Made it!
Improved, I must admit. That was a bloody good run. Be careful. Earn a reputation for talent around here, and some people get put out about it.
Sounds like you're speaking from experience.
Yes, well, I am. Anyway, you didn't do abysmally. I can't deny that. But you'll not have the same luck on the South Coast course.
We'll see, won't we? Till next time.
I half expected you to back down. Rest on your laurels. See you at the South Coast trial, if you don't lose your nerve.
Back from your latest flight. I want to hear all the particulars.
Good news, Mr. Weeks. With your upgrade, I was able to set a new record at the Irondale course.
Brilliant! I knew the upgrade had fantastic potential. How did your broom feel?
It rides well. Does get a tad shaky at top speed, and the handle wobbles a bit when I hit a strong gust of wind.
Ah, yes. I see. I think I know how to address that. Thank you. I owe you one.
If it means another upgrade, the pleasure's all mine.
You sound as determined as I am to improve broom flight. It's a joy to have a collaborator like yourself. If I'm right, and I do hope I am, you'll be hearing good news from me soon. Thank you again, truly.